Adrian, what have you done? What kind of question is that, Jules? I just killed your father and mine, of course. Hey, all you cool creatures. I'm Cryptid. Welcome to the Cryptid Plays YouTube channel, and today we are playing Mr. Adrian's Mansion is Creepy, which is yet another submission to the 6th annual Spooktober Visual Novel Jam. I'm playing a lot of these because it is the season. This is also the same person who did The Stranger from the Bus Stop, which, if you recall, I actually quite liked that one. It was a yandere one, but what this is about is that it's the 1980s. You are Jules, a history professor at a university who struggles to inspire your students. Your odd friend from when you were at an elite academy in the 70s invites you to his home to reconnect. This is a horror escape game visual novel with point and click elements. And it has 6 endings and should be about 20 minutes of gameplay. The content warnings include blood and violence, sounds of gunshots, manipulation, mentioned animal death, and overall disturbing imagery. So viewer discretion is advised. And with that out of the way, let's get started. All right. Cool. I don't know if anything shows up here. Okay. I like how this is set up like a CRT TV. That's kind of cool. What a terrible day. They always say there's that one university professor whose classes are so boring that attending is pointless. Oh, poor guy. I realize I'm that professor, and it hurts. I thought being passionate was enough to interest students, but it would be better if I adopted another strategy. Wait. I had a question, Professor. You don't seem to be one of my students. Indeed. I just wanted to get your attention. I suppose you don't recognize me. I think he does. Adrian, how about we forget the history lesson and just catch up like old friends? It's been a while, Jules. So now we're seeing their history. Adrian and I went to the same academy. We were among the top students, but we never spoke to each other. I was rather shy, always buried in my books, and he seemed too mature for our age. Since neither of us made the first move, we were destined to never talk. Until the day our parents became friends. I knew your son is the same age as my third son, so I brought him along today. I hope that's not a problem. Of course not. He'll be a great playmate for Adrian. Nice to have you here, Jules. god, this is creepy. Yes? We're in the same class. Go have some fun. Don't forget, Adrian, to be careful not to show him any private places. Of course, Father. I'll have to try and hone in on a proper voice for Adrian here. Jules has basically my voice. While our parents discussed politics and economics in the living room, we wandered around the house. We looked at paintings, played chess, or we'd flip through books in his enormous library. We explored the entire house to entertain ourselves, except for one room. There was this heavy wooden door that seemed to hide something. What's in there? The place where I hide my secrets. In other words, my room. Back then, Adrian was the kind of student everyone admired. Smart, charismatic, and distant. The perfect prodigy who, by chance, was also incredibly rich. What could he possibly want to hide? I don't know, man, rich people are weird. It made me itch to know what was behind that door. Not yet. What a surprise, Adrian. It must have been at least 13 years since we last saw each other. 14 years to the day, actually. Yes, that must be right. You've always had an impressive memory. You too. After all, you've become a prominent history professor. It's a job that suits you well, I must admit. Yeah. This is my first year teaching. I didn't have quite the charisma I'd hoped for. Don't say things like that. You're selling yourself short. That's not like you. And you? What have you been up to all this time? As you'd expect, I now run the company my father left me. Business as usual. Adrian, do you resent me? Resent you for what, Jules? We're still friends despite all these years. I feel like there's some resentment in those words. Life just kept us busy, that's all. But still, I've wondered if... When I heard that a new university professor had your name, I came by to check. Nothing more. That's exactly why I suggested we go to my old house. For old time's sake, right? Yeah, for old time's sake. Oh, we're already here. Stop in front of the gate. I love how Jules is visibly sweating. I don't blame him. Adrian's kinda creepy. The door is open. After you, Jules. No. You're not going in. Is something wrong? No, it's fine. Right? No. Can I choose no again? Okay. Yes, I guess. Your house has changed. Not really. It's more that time has altered your memories. Everything is almost identical. Don't be shy, Jules. Please, go wherever you want. I'll follow you. What the hell? Oh boy. The basement is so dark that it's impossible to see anything unless you go inside. Sure. Whoa! Oh. Are you okay? Ouch. Yes. I'm fine. There's a pile of stuff that cushioned my fall. We put all sorts of things in our basement. Everything we want to hide from others' eyes. I see, but I can't find a ladder or stairs. Can you help me? Adrian? I love these silhouettes with just the huge eyes. It's creepy. Adrian? Ending 3, trapped. So the doors are all of our endings. I see. Okay. Adrian's room is closed. I like how his is the only regular colored door. The chest is locked. Try to open it. Yes. You don't have the key. Okay. A phone booth? What? Okay. The booth is super small. You really used to make phone calls in this chilly place? What did you say? I didn't hear you. Wait. I'm coming. I was saying... No, don't come in, actually. We're really cramped in here now. You're my guest. I'm not going to abandon you. Okay. To make a call, please insert a coin. You have 5 seconds to insert a coin. Do you have one? No. Oh no. I don't know who's talking. No, I've only ever carried large bills. I don't have any change either. We should probably just get out of here for now. What is it? 3. The door's stuck. I can't get it open. to calm down. It's not that serious. One. Psh. Ending 5. Suffocation. At least we didn't die alone? The garden door is protected by a 4-digit code. It doesn't work. I don't know the code yet, so we need a code, we need a key. Adrian, who are these people in your library? I have no idea. Good evening, gentlemen. You seem a bit confused. So let me clarify the situation. I'm Virgil, the detective summoned to solve this murder case. Who is that silhouette? Our poor victim is a nameless butler, and these 3 individuals here are the suspects. Lydia, his partner, found out yesterday that he was cheating on her. I was angry, of course. I wasn't going to kill him for that. Tyler, his colleague, to whom he owed a considerable sum of money. If I had killed him, how would he have repaid me? That's absurd. And finally, this thing. I don't know. It looks like something capable of the worst. I think it's up to you to choose. Who do you think is the culprit? Click on the culprit. Me? That's ridiculous. I'm the detective. Why on earth would I do such a thing? Are you sure? Yeah? I know you are the murderer. It's exactly the same plot as in a book I used to love reading. I can't believe it. You have murder under the moonlight. You really do have every book imaginable. Only the ones worth reading. Father invests a lot in books. He thinks you get smarter by reading. And you, do you think so too? He's not wrong, but it's a boring debate. What makes this book so special? It's a murder mystery unlike any other. The detective, Virgil, solves perfect crimes throughout the book. At the end, you find out that he's the killer behind all the cases he pretended to solve, isn't he? And here I was just guessing, but okay. How did you guess? You were almost excited while telling it. It had to be something twisted. I see. So you will never read it. On the contrary, they say knowing the ending allows you to appreciate the story differently. If you recommend it, I'll give it a chance. Wake up, Jules. There's no one here. You obtained a revolver. It looks like something is beating inside. Is it a living cat? It broke my heart, you know. when this cat died, what? My father killed it to entertain his guests. He didn't care. It was just a stray animal, insignificant. But I knew you liked it, so I had it stuffed for you. As a memory. Huh. Look, Adrian, I think a guest wants to join our study session. This cat, it always comes back to scratch this window. It must be hoping we'll give it food, nothing more. Or maybe it's looking for a little affection. What are you doing? I'm just going to pet it, that's all. Don't you think it's adorable? Adorable, maybe. But it isn't here for us. Look at it. It seems happy. You're deluding yourself. Animals, like people, don't do anything without interest. No one seeks affection without something in return. You find a chess piece. King. A chess game. Sure. You know, Adrian, I saw you in the newspapers yesterday. It said, the young prodigy has once again beaten world champions with 30 years of experience. Sometimes I wonder if I'm not wasting your time by playing chess with you. You're so much better than me, I don't understand why you don't play to win. Because with you, I play for fun. You have your own way of playing. I try out moves and observe your strategies. I don't know how to take it. Why take it badly? I said I liked it. Adrian, what have you done? What kind of question is that, Jules? I just killed your father and mine, of course. Why did you do that? It was either them or us. They would have killed us. They were never real fathers to us. You know that as well as I do. Jules is truly a disappointment. He has no strength or tenacity. He carries the aura of a loser. I thought that by being around Adrian, he would improve. But there's no use. I'll just have to invest in his half-brother. I can't relate. Adrian is disciplined. He always meets my expectations, and I've done everything to ensure that. I use the same methods, but Jules doesn't react the same way. It doesn't toughen him up. He's showing himself to be weaker and weaker. What a mistake to have passed by the living room during those private confessions. So your father sees you as an extension of himself too, doesn't he? I'd rather have words than when he shows his displeasure in other ways. We're the same. You and me, Jules, trapped in their shadows. We'll never truly live in peace as long as they're around. The same? At least they respect you. If only you knew what people say about you. Nobody ever blames you for anything. Do you really care what others say? What makes you think I don't manipulate them? I don't know. Then trust me. What I'm telling you is the truth. We are the same. You obtained a coin from your dad. Oh. Let's do this again. You have 5 seconds to insert a coin. I think I have a coin in my pocket. Yes, I do. Well, I've never seen someone get so excited over a rusty coin. I'm glad to see you've kept that innocent side of yourself. You insert the coin. The phone rings. You should answer it, Jules. Jules, finally, you pick up. It's... I know who you are. You keep calling me. You keep avoiding me at school. You run away every time I show up. Your father comes to visit us, but you don't anymore. I'm just busy, that's all. Busy. You were never too busy before to give me a look. I just have a lot of studying to do. 0393. Alright. The garden door is open. Take the fishing rod. Yes. Jules. I've never been good at understanding why others pull away. It's probably because I don't function like they do. But you, I thought you were different. What you do with your time is none of my concern. I just wonder if you realize how much your behavior disturbs me. If one day you want to remember who you truly are, you know where to find me. I never forget anything. It would be wise not to tempt the devil and to stay here, though. Use the fishing rod. Mr. Jules, you're not opening the letters you're given. I don't want to read them. I understand, but Mr. Adrian insists that I check whether you read them. We don't see each other anymore. I don't know why he keeps sending them. I'm afraid Mr. Adrian hasn't accepted that yet. You should at least read them before things become too different. You fished out a key. Okay. So I'm getting, like, I've missed a few endings. I am gonna have to, like, basically go back and probably delete my saves. The chest is open. There's an old brown uniform and a diploma. Mr. Jules, your mother is waiting for you. The plane will leave soon. Jules, congratulations on your diploma with honors. I only came in second. The science subjects cost me first place. You've always preferred writing over calculating, haven't you? You're not going to tell me where you're going? I'm leaving too, you know. To the Academy for Heirs, managerial training and all that comes with it. If following in my father's footsteps is what's called success, then life promises to be dreadfully boring. I sent you one last letter. I hope you'll respond to this one.
Aww.
Adrian's room is open. I know you hate me. What? You envy me. Or is it that I stir up that inferiority complex you've always had since childhood? I would never be that vicious. It's not viciousness. It's who we are. We became so close. Then, suddenly, you couldn't stand me anymore. Not because I had changed, but because you never did.
You're wrong.
No, I don't think so. I'm the one who's always stayed in your mind. After all these years. No matter what happens or who you meet in the future, I've already taken what matters most. Your heart belongs to me and no one can ever give it back. I'll always be there, somewhere, reminding you that no one will ever reach you the way I did. In the end, I'm the one who wins. Ending 6, Heartless. After all this time, it's touching to know that a friend still thinks so much about us. In this abandoned house, nothing belongs to me anymore. Oh my, I'm sorry if the music got loud. I'm incredibly lucky to have you, Jules. I think without you, I would feel forgotten. I will never truly understand feelings. But, despite everything, I still appreciate you as much as ever. That has never changed. Don't wear that expression, it's merely a matter of poor timing, isn't it? However, if you seek forgiveness, just bring me flowers. They say flowers help soothe those who left too soon, don't they? I see it as an acknowledgement of what was lost. Your guilt is beautiful. I wish you could hold on to it forever. I have to get 3 other endings, I think. So I'm gonna go do that, but that was kind of sweet in a kind of toxic way. But I dig it. I kind of like Adrian. Anyhow, see you back at his place. Let's choose wrong. The stranger sneaked in and killed the first person they came across. Ending 1, Deceived. Open the cat, yes. The knife penetrates the poor cat's flesh. There's nothing inside.
Oh no, I hate this.
Jules? Why did you do that? To this cat? To our memory? What? I thought... ending to mutilated. Ending for eaten alive. Okay. Okay. So, gallery. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. We have all the endings. Before we do the outro, I just want to do my channel member shout out real quick. Thank you so much to my channel members for your support. It not only helps me, it helps the channel grow, and it helps the videos keep coming. I truly appreciate it. And now on to the outro. This was very surreal. I liked how it jumped into their memories, and I kind of liked how, even though it was very toxic, above all, Adrian seemed to adore Jules, and I thought that was kind of cute. Like, if I could choose a kind of toxicity that is actually fun, this would be it. It was strangely sweet in its own way. Okay, so the final ending was surprisingly easy to get because, once we did the murder mystery, I was just like, oh, click on the detective. Clearly I'm doing it wrong. Nope. That was the right choice, and it just continually led me down the right ones. I didn't want to cut open the cat because that made me sad. So, in the end, I guess just feeling bad and wanting to subvert expectations led me to the final ending. So that was kind of fun. But I really enjoyed how weird all of the endings were. Very creepy in its own way. Anyhow, before I ramble on too long, if you made it this far, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did like it, please hit that like button. And if you want to see more of me, please subscribe if you haven't already. I upload 3 times a week, so long as I'm not hindered in that. And I hope to see you all next time. Bye.